When I was growing up in Accra, my father died when I was 9, and it was my mother was the only one bringing in any income. It was very important for me and for my sister to be able to study and be able to get scholarships, because that's the only way we could educate ourselves. When I was growing up in the 60s, we heard President Kennedy's speech. He talked about having man land on the moon. And then in February 1962, we heard on the radio also that John Glenn circled the Earth 3 times. This was very exciting, and that gave us more interest in doing science and technology. Bell Labs recruits worldwide, so they came to Imperial College, where I was, to recruit. So I decided to come over to the U.S. and see what is happening in Bell Labs. 36 years later, having come to this country, I and my colleagues worked on some video coding and video encoders and decoding that was used to record some of John Glenn's second space flight in 1998. I didn't know that I would even be doing something like this in the future. I had good mentors throughout my career, and I always know that if you want to see far, you have to stand on somebody's shoulder. And so it's very important that I can have a strong shoulder for others to stand on and be able to encourage them to do even greater things than I have achieved.